Hi, this is Joe. I just welcome you here to see 10 real facts about the Bermuda Triangle. Do subscribe me.
I had this strange sensation, and it felt like zero gravity. It only lasted about 10 seconds. I felt like I was slipping forward through space, and yet floating at the same time.
All right, coming in at number 10, we have the mystery light. In 1492, Christopher Columbus was on board the Santa Maria with his crew on his first voyage to the New World. He sailed through the area we now know as the Bermuda Triangle and reported seeing fire on the horizon, despite there being no discernible land. He wrote in his diary describing the flame as a small wax candle that rose and lifted up. On investigation, they couldn't get to the bottom of what it was. In modern times, people attribute the light to Columbus witnessing a meteor crash. Others, not so convinced. Coming in at number 9, Bruce Gernon and the Time Warp. A lot of the Bermuda Triangle encounters happened a long time ago, or there simply aren't any key eyewitnesses to discuss their experiences. Bruce Gernon is very much alive and kicking, and he had a very strange experience flying over the Bermuda Triangle on his way to Palm Beach in the 1970s. At the time, he was an experienced personal pilot and a grown-up flying with his dad. Shortly after taking off from Andros in the Bahamas, Gernon came across a storm, so he tried to fly around it. He found a strange tunnel in the clouds and decided he's gonna fly through it. Here's what he had to say about it.
The airplane penetrated into the tunnel. These strange lines formed.
Right. Okay, so that's what he had to say. In the tunnel, he said he had a feeling as if he was slipping through time and space. He said that when he got out of the cloud tunnel after 20 seconds, the Miami air controllers had been worried as his plane had totally disappeared off their radars. He described an electromagnetic yellow-grayish fog surrounding the plane and messing with his instruments. When he emerged from the fog, he thought that he was going to be over Bimini, but air control told him that actually, he was flying directly over Miami Beach. What should have taken him around 80 minutes of flight time had only taken 34 minutes. He was baffled. He seems to have traveled 100 miles in just 3 minutes. So this is roughly 1,918 miles per hour, when his plane was only capable of traveling at 200 miles per hour. Weird. Famous pilot Charles Lindbergh also reported something very similar in the area. Weird. Coming in at number 8, we have the Ellen Austin encounter. In 1880, the Ellen Austin came across an unidentified schooner ship drifting in the Bermuda Triangle's Sargasso Sea. Now, it was sailing a very weird, erratic path, and Captain Baker of the Ellen Austin decided to trail the ship for 2 days just to check it wasn't a trap. After 48 hours, the Ellen Austin came close to the boat and received no return signal. Captain Baker decided to send 4 of his men on board to investigate the ship. Weapons drawn, they got no response. On investigation, they saw no signs of life, but also no signs of struggle. The only thing that seemed awry was that the entire crew were missing, and curiously, as was the ship's logbook. Finding a perfect stash of mahogany on board, the captain formed a prize crew of his most trusted men and ordered that they sailed the ship to New York. Days later, the Ellen Austin came across the very same vessel again. Now, they sent out signals, and once again, it was met with no response. Again, the ship seemed to be drifting aimlessly. Captain Baker sent more men over, who found their prize crew totally absent, again without signs of a fray, and again the logbook was missing. Captain Baker's crew were freaked out, but he demanded that a small crew of new men once again try and steer the boat and its bounty to New York. It took hours of convincing, as many thought that the ship was cursed. However, he did manage to assemble a crew. Now, that was the last anyone ever saw of the schooner or the crew ever again. They simply disappeared. Coming into number 7, we have the missing USS Cyclops. After departing Barbados on the 4th of March 1918, the USS Cyclops went missing without a trace, with a crew of 309 people. The ship was carrying a whole load of manganese ore and was never seen again, leaving absolutely no trace. Now, by this point, it's a very familiar story. The incident was the single greatest loss of life in the history of the US Navy, whilst not actively engaged in combat. Was the ship too heavy, or did the Bermuda Triangle pull it down to its murky depths? Coming into number 6, we have Carol A. endearing. Good old Carol was the name of a 5-masted schooner. She'd been afloat for 3 years when she was found run aground and abandoned on the 31st of January 1921, which is exactly 98 years ago on the day that I scripted this video, which is really spooky. The wreck was found in Cape Hatteras in North Carolina, but she was supposed to be sailing from Puerto Rico to Rio, right in the heart of the Bermuda Triangle. She was gonna cut straight through it. Now, no trace of the crew were ever found. Some people speculated mutiny, others say the ship may have been attacked by pirates, citing the Prohibition era of the incident. Sadly, we will never know. Coming into number 5, we have the 2017 Turkish Airline incident. So this is actually very recent. In February 2017, Turkish Airlines flight TK-183 encountered some strange problems as it flew over the Bermuda Triangle. It seems that the Airbus A330-200 was forced to change its direction from Havana, Cuba to Washington Dulles Airport. The pilot and crew reported mechanical and electrical problems. Now, electrical problems, after what we've already heard, to me, that's just pretty interesting. Coming into number 4, this is a little bit more tin hat, we have the Lost City of Atlantis. The legend of the Lost City of Atlantis claims that the city radiated a mysterious energy that caused navigational instruments to break down, which kind of sounds like what we know from the area. Is the Lost City of Atlantis under the Bermuda Triangle? The legend of Atlantis also talks about interesting rock formations on the ocean bed. Now, these are rather like some of those located on the ocean bed in the Bahamas. These are called Bimini Road. Some mystics believe that Atlantis lies at the very, very bottom of the murky depths, and the energy of the lost souls, the ghosts of the drowned citizens, are what are causing the disappearances and luring people to their watery deaths, leaving absolutely no trace to the outside world. Honestly, I'm not sold on this one. Coming into number 3, we have the alien wreckage. Discovery Channel host Daryl Miklos was filming a show whilst diving in the Caribbean using maps made by former NASA astronaut Gordon Cooper. Now, he was in search of old shipwrecks and magnetic anomalies. He was investigating what he thought might be an ancient shipwreck, but it turns out it was something else entirely. Miklos described it as a formation unlike anything he had ever seen, being far too big for a shipwreck, he also said. Now, he said something which I thought was really interesting. He said, it was something that was completely different from anything that I've ever seen made by nature. This led him to speculate that actually, it might be something entirely unearthly. Miklos also found another strange object and formation all around the big puzzling object, all of which are covered in thick coral, thought to date back hundreds upon hundreds of years. When Miklos studied Cooper's work, he found that the astronaut believed in aliens. Now, this led to the Discovery Channel host speculating that the mysterious wreckage could be a crashed alien spaceship. Because, you know, what else? Coming into number 2, we have the UFOs over the triangle. Can we explain the Bermuda Triangle with aliens? Maybe. It seems that there was a terrifying alien encounter on board the USS John F. Kennedy in the 1970s, but crew on board the ship were told by the captain to keep shtum. It seems that the ship was set to return to Virginia after 2 weeks in the Caribbean, and was in the middle of the ocean when the crew on deck looked up to see a large glowing sphere around 200 to 300 feet in diameter. One eyewitness said it was yellow and orange in color, and all of the radar screens on board the boat lit up. Naval officers tried to deploy 2 F-4 Phantoms to intercept the UFO, but they simply wouldn't start. Eventually, the UFO moved on days later, and as the ship was making its approach back to the USA, the captain warned the crew against speaking of the incident. This isn't the only time it's happened either. It seems Google Maps shows a UFO just outside of the triangle. Finally, coming into number 1, we have the disappearance of Flight 19. Now, this is the most famed legend surrounding the Bermuda Triangle, and one of the hardest to explain. It all went down on December 5th, 1945, when 5 TBM Avenger bombers, grouped as Flight 19, were flying over the Bermuda Triangle. The flight never returned to Fort Lauderdale as planned, and the worst was feared, with the general theory being that something had gone wrong and the planes had run out of fuel. As there were 14 men lost, the Navy sent out a rescue mission to search for survivors, or at least to confirm the wreck. 13 crew were set off on the Martin PBM Mariner flying boat, but that flight never made it back either. Neither wrecks have ever been found, nor have any traces of the missing people. Now, the story made international news and helped perpetuate the legend of the Bermuda Triangle. So guys, that was the top 10 scary Bermuda Triangle stories. Which of these did you think was the scariest? Do you believe in the legends of the Bermuda Triangle? What do you think is causing the strange occurrences? I want to say aliens, but I don't think it's aliens. Thank you guys once again for watching this video. Don't forget to leave me your craziest conspiracy theories about the Bermuda Triangle. I cannot wait to hear them. Please do leave a thumbs up on this video. Share it with a friend.